So basically, at the bottom of the Pacific, you've got all these stones lying around which nobody can see, but everybody can remember who they belong to. That's Bitcoin. Do you need it any more technical than that?
Bitcoin is essentially a distributed, open, public ledger of transactions. So every transaction that takes place is recorded and everybody knows it. And that's a very exciting and interesting technology. It means that you don't have a central authority that you have to refer to in order to find out whether something's real or not. Everybody can see the blockchain, everybody can see all the transactions. Now, obviously, there's a little bit of cleverness that goes into that because you need cryptography to protect these transactions so that people can't go back and change them. And the way that cryptography works is that it rewards people with Bitcoins themselves for doing the work to maintain that blockchain.
I think tonight's lecture was very, very interesting. I mean, I've learned a little about Bitcoin in my time, but to be honest, this took it a stage further. I've always had concerns about Bitcoin as a currency because it is so volatile and it's not linked to a state, so it's going to continue to have that volatility. And therefore, I've always thought of it more as a commodity. But we have people this evening who are talking about taking that a stage further and not just using Bitcoin, but using the blockchain in order to verify all sorts of transactions and indeed at the end of the day, to be a custodian of even material goods. And that's, if that can happen, that's quite an exciting and radical change to society.
I thought tonight's lecture was incredibly valuable and educational in terms of what Bitcoin is, but also what the blockchain is. And that's something that I'm going to take away, especially around what the different applications for the blockchain are and the opportunities that are going to arise from them in the future for businesses and also, you know, any industry.
I think Bitcoin is the first iteration of the world's of a privatized currency. Up until now, all the world currencies are controlled, managed, and issued by governments, central banks, and banks. Bitcoin is the world's first private digitized currency, which is issued by people, not by governments.
What should we be telling the members? I think we need to tell them it's something that's going to happen, whether it's Bitcoin or whether it's something else. People need to have some understanding of the technology and to be aware of what's going to happen and think about the impact it's going to have on them
now,
individually and as a profession.
I think Bitcoin, or more specifically the blockchain, does have the potential to be a disruptive technology. I mean, that's one of the reasons why you see so much venture capital money pouring into it. Whether it will disrupt the banks, I'm not sure, because you see, if the technology works, if it does provide, for example, a radically cheaper way of managing securities, then banks will use it. It won't disrupt them. They'll use it. Are there other businesses that might be disrupted? Businesses who rely on the fact that you have to have these centralized authorities? Possibly.
I don't think most of our members, frankly, need to be that worried about what they should do with Bitcoin in the near future. I think providing people realize that it is very much a commodity and it can go up and down in value, and you should treat it more like an option or some form of fairly liquid investment, but nevertheless a volatile investment, then I think most of our members have the skills and shouldn't be over worried about it. If we move on to the future and it does become a currency, then I think there's a whole new area we have to look at, but I don't think that's really going to happen very much in the short term, quite frankly.
I mean, whether we're all going to be using Bitcoins in the future or not, to be honest, I'm slightly skeptical. Bitcoin to me, and remember I'm old school, so Bitcoin to me doesn't seem a terribly good money system, it doesn't seem a terribly good payment system. But that underlying technology of the open distributed public ledger is a very, very interesting technology. And there are lots of people who are looking at lots of applications of that ledger for everything from land registries to securities to new kinds of money which work in a very different way. And there's a lot of excitement about that. And I share that excitement. I think this is a radically new technology. Whether money is the best use of it or not, I'm not so sure.